Good evening, girls. Now, we were talking about the lymphoid organs, the primary lymphoid organs. So here, the third primary lymphoid organ is bursa of Fabricius. Now, what do you understand by the term bursa of Fabricius? I have been telling you from starting itself, in human beings, you have only two primary lymphoid organs, which is the thymus and the bone marrow. Whereas in apes, that is the birds, you have bursa of Fabricius. And where is this located? The bursa of Fabricius is located near the cloacal region. It does have the primary lymphoid organs like the thymus, the bone marrow, and the secondary lymphoid organ, the spleen. In spite of all these things, it has another lymphoid organ, which is the primary lymphoid organ called as the bursa of Fabricius. It is present in apes and absent in the mammals. Now, this is the structure of a bursa of Fabricius. It's a single lobule. First, I'll do a little bit of the theory of it, and then in detail we look at the diagram. It is the primary lymphoid organ found in the birds. B cells mature in the bursa of Fabricius. Do you understand the point here? They are produced in the bone marrow, but they mature in the bursa of Fabricius. It is a sac-like lymphoendothelial structure attached to the cloaca. You can see it is sac-like, it is slack-like. It is made up of endothelial cells but lymphatic cells too. So it is called as lymphoendothelial structure, and which is attached to the cloaca. It is formed of many follicles. Each follicle has an outer cortex and an inner medulla. This is the outer cortex, this yellow region, and this is the inner medulla. So as we have seen the thymus structure also, right? Outer cortex and inner medulla. Here also you have the outer cortex and the inner medulla. What are the two main functions of bursa of Fabricius? The B cell maturation and the humoral immunity. These are the two major functions of bursa of Fabricius in apes. Now, as you have thymectomy, you have what is called as a bursectomy also. Usually this thymectomy, bursectomy, all these experiments are conducted as a proof for the function of that organ. So what happens here? If you remove the bursa of Fabricius in neonatal, that is newborn birds, has a damaging effect on the antibody synthesis and humoral immunity, but does not affect the CMI, because the thymus is already there. So cell mediated immunity will be taken care by the thymus, but only thing that the antibody synthesis will be impaired, and all the humoral immunity also will be impaired. And the bursectomized birds are devoid of the plasma cells also, because we saw in the bone marrow in humans, right, they are responsible for the production of plasma cells. Now, as you remove the bursa of Fabricius, the plasma cells are also absent. So with this, we come to the end of bursa of Fabricius. This is how the structure is. This is the green color structure are the antigens. When they enter in, you have the cortex region. In the cortex region, you have the macrophages, and inside the medulla, you have what is called as the reticuloendothelial cells, and this outer membrane and this outer membrane of the medulla and cortex is called as the basement. So you can see this here, the one running up here, coming down and going up till here is called as the basement membrane. You understand? So these are the bursal cells. The cells inside the bursa are called as bursal cells. There are also what is called as bursal secretory dendritic cells. They are called as BSDC. It can be asked as a objective question. So please remember, they are bursal secretory dendritic cells. Their function itself is in their name. They are secretory in nature. You have the capillary vessels, you have the lymphoblast and the mesenchyma reticular cells. So this is the general structure of bursa of Fabricius.